Whether or not you're a fan of horse racing, you probably know what the Kentucky Derby is. And when the race returns to NBC this weekend, it will give us a chance to resume one of our favorite pastimes, cheering for anyone and anything that has ever had a connection to Minnesota. This one's actually real. There are some horses with Minnesota owners in this race, right, Kent? And they got a shot.
They do have a shot. There are two horses. One of them is actually the betting favorite, Jenna, and the other is an up-and-coming long shot. Now, before this year, we've only had two Minnesota-owned horses ever make the field. But surprisingly, history is on our side here.
If you're a Minnesotan who likes cheering for one of us,
time for the most exciting 2 minutes in sports.
You've got more than one horse in the race.
They're all in line
for this year's Kentucky Derby.
They're off.
And yes, the odds of that are long.
It's the third and fourth time ever. Just happened to have two of them in the same year, but with horses that begin with the letter Z.
Barry and Joni Butzo of Eden Prairie are the owners of Zozos, a thoroughbred they bred themselves.
It's like taking one of your kids to the Derby. It's pretty special.
Special because Zozos is their first Derby horse in a nearly 40-year Hall of Fame career at Canterbury Park.
If it weren't for Canterbury, we wouldn't even be in the racing. Started in 1985 when Canterbury opened, so we bought one horse. Unfortunately, the horse won its first race, and so you're in for life.
Zozos, on the other hand, is pretty new to all of this.
There's only one other horse in the race that's had less races than we've had.
Zozos gains the advantage.
After winning his first ever race in January, Zozos really made strides in race number two.
He is just running up the score. Zozos clear to the wire. He's 10 in front.
He just stood out and got picked up on by all the horse media and stuff. The hot shot horse, if you will.
Up and coming, yeah.
Zozos qualified for the Derby by race number three.
Both inside Zozos.
And though one of the Derby favorites passed him down the stretch,
coming past the 16th,
he showed he's got more to give.
He was about two lengths behind in closing, so it'll be interesting.
Interesting also describes the journey of that other Minnesota-owned horse and current Derby favorite, Zandon.
He was a bit of a late bloomer, if you will, as a two-year-old.
Owner Jeff Drown of St. Cloud bought Zandon at auction, but didn't really know what he had until he saw him compete.
He was coming from behind in a lot of races. He got bumped a lot. He's taken a lot of dirt. All things that young horses usually struggle with, and he's fought through all of that.
And that was all on display during last month's Toyota Bluegrass Stakes.
And Zandon is running late
and pulling off one of the biggest comebacks you'll see.
Zandon has moved through all kinds of traffic from the back of the pack, and he is now taking command in deep stretch. It's over.
To have a horse that's coming in a top class form and training at the level he's at, winning the grade one Bluegrass in his last race, that's really gives you a lot of confidence that we'll have a good shot.
And whether you favor a favorite who closes fast or delight in a dark horse who runs out front,
and I watch every morning,
racing analyst Kevin Gorg says Minnesotans can't go wrong.
Both horses have looked spectacular leading up to this race, so it's exciting. Whether it's all the speed horses hang in there or it favors the closers, if you're Team Minnesota, you've got one of each.
And if one of them wins, they would join Unbridled in 1990 as the only other Minnesota-owned winner.
Unbridled takes command!
Though it will be hard to top the celebration by Minnesotan Francis Genter, who is 92 at the time.
Oh yeah, huge. You're going to see that clip on the air 50 times.
Mrs. Genter, you're going to win the Derby.
And proof that anything is possible when you have a horse, make that two horses in the race.
It's awfully special.
Both of us tear up. We know how much work it takes to get a horse there. So we're just hoping he stays calm with 150,000 people there.
Now, if you are looking for a Minnesota trifecta, the Star Tribune just reported that there will now be one more horse with a slight Minnesota connection racing this weekend. Pete Mattson, an owner and breeder from Prior Lake, just bought a 1% interest in the horse Mo Donegal, Jana. There you go. That's about as far reaching as you can get.
No, it's not. I love that it's a 1% stake because that's the most Minnesota thing I've heard in addition to your story today. I'm curious, yeah. Zozos, did they tell you why they named the horse Zozos?
You know, it goes to a restaurant, I think, in the Virgin Islands that they really liked there, if I remember correctly. We didn't get too into that, but they're excited. It's so fun.
Okay, if you had a horse and you named it after your favorite restaurant, what would it be?
Oh, man, Olive Garden? Just kidding. I don't know.
Olive Garden comes from behind.
Free breadsticks.
Soup and salad for everybody. Oh, it's not even a dad joke and you embarrassed yourself. We appreciate it, Kent. We'll be watching this weekend.